So what I'm going to do is, I'll share my story with you guys. While they open the presentation, I was born and brought up in Godavari Kani. It's a small town in Karimnagar district. My father worked in Singareni Collieries. All my father wanted as is to become government teachers. We are three brothers. We studied hard. We did graduation, then post-graduation. With three of us become software engineers. My father didn't like us. So I started my career with SAP India in Bangalore as a SAP consultant. I worked there for 12 years, then HP, then Capgemini. Capgemini felt that I better perform in Europe. They posted me in Capgemini, Netherlands. I worked there for 7 years. But then something very unfortunate happened with our family. We lost our elder brother to cancer. He is a national champion in swimming. He never smoked, he never had alcohol, nor we had any family history of cancer. Yet we lost him to cancer. So it's like a big disaster to whole family. We are a very, very affectionate family. So it didn't go well. I came back and I didn't go back to my job. 3 months I was sitting at home doing nothing. My parents worried that he might become sick again, one more guy. But one day I wanted to do something. Though I was full of sorrow, but there's an anger coming out of it slowly. And there's a revenge kind of mood I was in. I wanted to do something. I was there with my brother in hospital for 3 months, and I couldn't do anything stopping him. So I'm very serious, and I wanted to do something. And I'm not a doctor, nor I can do MBBS now. So I was thinking, is there a way to prevent this happening to others? So I was in search for that. So one day I went to my farm. We have a 8.5 acre land. My father is doing farming then. I read the box there, the pesticide we spraying for vegetables. It's called monocrotopus. It's very clearly written on that excess use will cause cancer. And then that made me curious, and I read all the pesticides we are using in the farm, the other neighbors spraying in the farm. All of them are carcinogenic. And that's where it started, and I started researching through Google, though. And I found so many disturbing facts. Can you please open that PPT? You might have heard so much of food adulteration as well regarding, it's on desktop. So he's my brother who inspired me for this. If you look at the problem, our farmers, we depend on pesticides, chemical pesticides heavily, which are not only destroying the farmer's health. If you can see, he's the one who's first to be impacted because he's breathing it. And most of our farmers in Telangana, whomever I spoke to, has asthma-related problem, excess sweating, things like this. What are you doing? It's working. Just leave. Yeah. And the number, it's not only farmer. When he's spraying these pesticides, he's not only killing the bad pest, but also good pest, like earthworms and honeybees. Take earthworms. They are friends of soil. Without earthworm, the earthworms, they always dig the soil, and it helps rainwater to penetrate. And we lost them to these synthetic chemicals, equally to bees. So while spraying this pesticide, he's not only destroying his health, but also he's destroying the ecological balance. What about the consumers? We eating at urban spaces and villages. We are eating this kind of food, and the stat says this is the reason causing all these modern day diseases. So I wanted to find a solution to address these both problems, where the farmer's health has been improved, his income has been improved, and the urban consumer like us get a pesticide-free meal. That's where I started Organic Thali. So we are working closely with 20, 28 farmers now in nearby Hyderabad, whom we have trained, and they are not using any pesticides and doing organic farming. They are certified now. We are procuring directly, and we have a central kitchen in Madhapur where we prepare these everyday delicious meals and we serve in corporates. These are my current clients. We are also there in T-Hub canteen now from last 2 weeks. How many of you had organic thali in T-Hub? Yeah, those who are allowed inside, we have a canteen there. Most of our clients says, see, we see this. In the name of healthy food, people make it boring. No taste in it. We want to avoid that. Our aim is to make it as spicy as it is, everyday meal, yet healthy. And many of our customers who had our food says it's very tasty. We are not feeling sleepy post-lunch. In IT, we all experience that post-lunch giddiness, which kills at least 1 hour productivity. After lunch, you have to have a tea or coffee to come back to your productivity. So with our thali, many say that they're not feeling that giddiness after lunch. And many say their stomach-related, digestive, ulcer-related problems have gone. We have done nothing, guys. We just avoided using pesticides at farm level. We also introduced few healthy habits, like while cooking, we don't use normal salt, but we use this Himalayan pink salt. Our milk is organic milk. So small steps, creating a lot of impact for consumers. So these are a few peaks, our kitchen team and my main core farming team. Now I'm having 2 years of organic farming experience, apart from that 13 years of IT consulting experience. So while this is a business, when I started this business, I want to make it self-sustainable. Though I've raised some money, I'm also an incubator of IIM Calcutta. They helped me with some seed fund. But I want to make it a self-sustainable business model and grow it organically. So I'm doing it slowly, one step at a time. But at the same time, I want to make money, but same time, we are generating a considerable amount of impact. If you look at the ecological balance, because of our market, we are creating a market for organic farmers. Like that, 24 farmers are directly connected through us. So with these 24 farmers, around 90-acre land is being protected from those dangerous pesticides. 28 farmers, as I said, their income and health both have improved. Our milk, like I said, the dairy industry is very cruel nowadays. They inject, they take away calves early. Nowadays, we also find hormones, synthetic milk. So our milk, we take them very holistic way. We don't inject. Everything is holistic. And more than 1,200 customers we are serving our food now, and they're all happy and healthy. I'm not sure about apple. There's a saying, one apple a day, but I can certainly say one organic thali can keep the doctor away. Thank you. You can ask me if you have any questions.
Any questions?
Yes.
Or the people are using pesticides to grow the food or crop fast and on more productive, right? So how you have convinced them, or like what is the model, right? How you have convinced them?
The convincing part, yeah. See, there are enough information available, which is better. But convincing is a difficult task. So how we did is, we went to one farmer, we convinced him, we shown him some market and business. Through his example, we convinced other 20 people. So farmers won't believe numbers and all these PPTs. They need some proof. So we proved that this farmer is, and the farmers, when this farmer tells, even the clients, you never saw us in the market, right? We don't do any marketing and stuff like that, branding. We believed in the one who had our organic thali should tell the others. That's how we got other eight clients. That's the best proof.
Thank you.
Actually, I was watching one video in like one of the news channel. They said that they use injection to inject that pumpkin or the cucumber to grow like more size. So they will, the farmer has to do that because in order to sustain or like survive, if they will sell that 1 kg pumpkin at that, rather than like natural grown pumpkin, right? So they will get more benefit or like money.
Yeah.
So I don't know. Knowingly or unknowingly, they are like selling the poison to the people.
Yes.
So my question is like, I'm from like farming background, my parents and then it's very difficult to convince them. They had a good land. When I go and say that, hey, don't use pesticides, they just give that answer.
Yeah, I completely agree with you. It's a common question and answer from any farmer. You go and tell this algan to him, he'll sell. If I lose any money, will you pay it? And it so happened one farmer came to my house with his family with a pesticide. He lost 50,000 that season. And he said, if you don't pay, I'll commit suicide. I agree with that problems. But if like people like us with IT background and little intelligence should work out, do something, create market for these organic products. As you said correctly, that oxytocin hormone, they have to inject because we are buying which are looking good. The organic vegetables or fruits won't look, they are not glamorous. The banana is not at all glamorous. So we consumers are driving that, in fact, not the farmer. Many farmers tells me, sir, this nobody will buy this tomato or banana. So we look for apple which is shining. It has to be wax coated. A banana, it should be yellowish and should look good. So guys, we should get some knowledge about our food, and that's how we should drive. The consumer should drive. Like I took up this and I'm helping few farmers. So if you can take up, and the many are, I heard eSagu, there's so many people are trying this. So join the team and do something.
Thank you, sir, for providing a practitioner's view of social entrepreneurship.